right. This is a real story, real true story. And I know it because I was working in that company. Now, to protect the person's identity, let's call the person Charlie. Now, in this company, Charlie was the most disliked guy. Nobody liked him. The owner didn't like him. The workers didn't like him. Except maybe his manager or one, two senior people. Rest, even the owner didn't like him. His attitude, and he was a rebel. But the people who hated him the most were all his... The people who hated him were all his colleagues. Imagine a large firm of roughly 60, 70... Not large firm, you could say small, medium size, 60, 70 employees, and around 60 of them hate you, okay? Including the owner. Now, the first question that comes to, that should come to mind is, if almost 90% of everyone hates him, including the owner, why is he still having a job? Why didn't they terminate him? Now, here's something surprising for you. The reason why he didn't get terminated, there's only one reason. There's no two, three reasons, whatever. The only reason he never got terminated is because he was so good at his job. He was so amazing. Every client would ask for him when there was an issue, when there was a problem. Every customer service would ask for him. Every person in the industry, they wanted to employ him. He was that good. And, when I was part of this company, even I didn't like him. Couldn't tolerate him. I wanted him terminated. I even asked the owner, why didn't you terminate this guy? He told him, Loy, I hate his guts. Can't stand him. But he does the job of 10 people. He is the number one, the best in the company. But I never let him know this. And to get someone like him, I don't know. Either I have to pay 4 or 5 times more, or I might never get. He's saying right now, if I were to terminate him, within a minute, people coming to know, they will scoop him up. You know, this... This incident stayed with me for many, many years. It really hit a home run. It made me think like, fuck, man. This guy is an asshole. His ego is up in the air. He's difficult to work with. People can't stand him. But he is not being terminated. In fact, he asked for his termination. He asked for his, don't terminate me, let me go. The owner, to make sure that he stayed, gave him a house, gave him bank loan, gave him all this interest free. So he took it. But he would never let him go. Now, what has this story got to do with anything? If you actually look at my profile online, my YouTube, my videos, my comments, have you noticed I don't give a fuck? I don't care a damn. Like, I tell people, no, see, that doesn't mean I take advantage of the situation. See, just because you're rich and successful, you can act like an asshole, you can disrespect people, you can molest men and women. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about being true to yourself. Now, in my case, for example, I'll give you a good example. My previous video that I posted was about why I don't respect my wife. Okay. The gist of the whole video, if you watch it, it comes down to respect has to be earned, not given by default. That's what I mean. And every day you have to earn your stripes. every day I have to earn my stripes, every day she has to earn her stripes, every day the baby has to earn their stripes. So it's not like you do one good thing and for the rest of your life you can enjoy the perks and benefits. It's like, for example, my daughter, suppose she gets first rank, I'm just saying, she gets the highest marks in the class. So does that mean for the next 12 years of her life, she can sit back and not be bothered? No. Every day, she has to work harder. Same thing with my wife. Every day, she has responsibilities. Same thing with me. Every day, I have responsibilities. And we should not only execute our responsibilities, we should strive to be the best. That is my mantra. That is my philosophy. You can't be, like, you know, example I gave, if you're cleaning, don't clean like this. Remove everything. Keep everything in order. Properly clean, disinfect, make it spick and span, polish it. And then when you're putting all the stuff back, clean everything, make it look like brand new, perfect. That should be how people should aspire to be. Those are my standards. And I push and challenge my wife to reach those lofty standards. It's not that I'm the best in the world, but I strive to be. So with whatever limited I can, same thing. Because, you know, I'm 44. My wife is 20 something. 27 or 28 or whatever. I will die first. She'll be left alone. So then who's going to earn? Who's going to feed you? Are you going to survive? So I have to work hard. So I have to be the best. Now, anyway, don't want to dwell on that. So, many people have sent me messages, Loy, I've lost respect for you. I'm unsubscribing. And then there are these other people, Loy, listen, man, don't share your personal stuff, your personal beliefs. People will not like you for it. Don't be so honest. See, I'm not online for a popularity contest. You know, like these film actors and actresses. The best example is The Rock. Best example is Biden. They will do and say things to keep everyone happy. If someone says, I'm transgender, okay, fine. Call me they, them. They'll say they, them. Oh, I apologize. Oh, I wore this outfit. Oh, you felt offended. I'm so sorry. Yeah, because they have a PR agency. They have studios that don't want to work with them if they don't dance to their tunes. Me, from an early age, I decided I'm not going to dance to people's tunes because I don't like. As it is, you have customers, clients. As it is, earning your livelihood is a struggle and difficult. As it is, managing a family is hard enough. As it is, there are enough and more challenges to life. On top of that, you want to dance to everyone? That's why for me, if I have less subscribers, I'm happy. Less headache. I don't want to be world famous. I don't mind being world famous, provided I'm not asked to dance to people's tunes. If people are asking me to dance to their tunes, I don't need them. Like I told people, I don't mind having, let's say, 50,000 subscribers. I'm right now 42 or 43, I don't know. Don't check also. Let's say 40,000 subscribers. I'm happy if I get stuck at that. Provided I don't have to dance to anyone. And provided I'm earning enough to support my family. Yes, I would be concerned if my earnings go to zero. Now, I'm not saying that commit a crime, harm someone. You know, like there are pedophiles, there are drug addicts, there are murderers, killers, racist individuals. No, that is, you need to use common sense. That you're breaking the law. I'm not asking you to break the law. All I'm saying is, focus on being so good at your craft, at what you do. So good that nobody can challenge you. That you are the best. You know, there are so many people who can't stand me, who don't like my views. But then they have no choice but to come back to me, take my service. And when I give them my service, they're very happy. They tell me, Loy, I don't agree with your views. I don't like you. But your work is amazing, man. For me, that is the biggest compliment. The biggest. And you could say, this is something I learned because of my experience. You need to be so good, so amazing, that people, whether they like you, whether they hate you, they can't ignore you. And that is a mark of being successful. I would rather be the world's best, number one, a legend at what I do, my work, and be hated by everyone. You could say Nikola, Tesla, Michael Jackson, they're legends. Rather than be a substandard who's kissing everyone's ass and pleasing everyone and giving a substandard product. The great Steve Jobs, he was like that. In today's day and age, I'm sure Steve Jobs would have been sued. George Lucas. Yeah, why he stopped making this movie? Because everyone, no, I'm offended. Oh, every Tom, Dick and Harry useless idiot who had an internet connection talking shit. So think, whether Elon Musk, anybody, be so good, so amazing, that even if they hate you, they can't ignore you. That's what I leave you with. That is why I respect only those people who are good at what they do, their work. And I don't give a fuck to those people who are busy kissing everyone's ass. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Okay? It's me signing off. You guys take care.